Are you at a high risk to develop breast cancer? Today we shall talk about hereditary breast cancer. Greetings my friends, I'm Dr. Rajeev Vijayakumar, a consultant in medical oncology at BGS Clinicals Global Hospitals, Bangalore. Today we shall talk about whether you have a chance of developing breast cancer because either a close family member like a mother or a grandmother or a sibling like a sister has developed breast cancer. For our information, 5 to 10% of all breast cancers can be hereditary. That is, it can come from one generation to the other. But you might say, oh, in my family, no one's had a breast cancer. Nam vamshadalli yargu bandilla. Mere pure khandan mein kisi ko cancer hi nahi hua. Just because one of your relatives develop cancer, it does not mean that you too are destined to develop a cancer. There are certain tests to find out. What are these? These are hereditary breast cancer panel testing. So where do we start with? If your loved one or your relative who's a cancer patient is yet there, we can do these tests on her blood sample. Does it mean that you are destined to develop a breast cancer? Not necessarily. If you have a loved one who has had a breast cancer and you are doubtful whether you have a higher chance of developing the breast cancer, there are certain hereditary breast cancer panel testings which can be done. This is done on the index case, that is the affected patient. You take a buccal swab or you take a sample of blood, and on the WBCs or on the tumor cells, wherever there is DNA, you extract the DNA, identify whether there are certain known mutations exists. What are the most common mutations that we know of? These mutations are called BRCA1 and 2 or the BRCA1 and 2. Remember the famous Hollywood star Angelina Jolie? Her mother, her grandmother had ovarian cancer. So as a very preventive measure, she got herself tested and she also harbored the same genes, that is a BRCA2 mutation, in lieu of which she underwent the surgeries, that prophylactic bilateral mastectomy and oophorectomy, that is removal of both the breasts and removal of both the ovaries. Do we need to do that for you? Not anymore. There are a lot of screening tests which we can do to prevent you from undergoing a radical surgery such as that. Well, but coming back to the point, so there are certain tests to identify whether you have a higher risk of developing a cancer or not. And it's not just breast cancer. If these mutations are present, it can lead to a variety of cancers. It can lead to ovarian cancer, endometrial cancers, some kind of form of GI cancers, and even pancreatic cancers. So by getting these tests done, that is the hereditary breast cancer panel testing, it is easy for us to know whether the relative, that is you who is not affected, has a higher chance of developing a breast cancer or any of these cancers. And if it comes positive, all we have to do is do very concise and very decisive screening on all of these organ systems which I just mentioned, that is breasts, ovaries, pancreas, endometrium, that is the uterus, and then afterwards the GI system as well. By doing these tests on a regular basis, we call them screening methods, once every 6 months or a year, if there is an onset of a cancer, you can catch it at its inception, that is just in its beginning stage, get done with it and lead a very normal and happy life. Is BRCA1 and 2 the only mutations which are responsible for transfer of cancer from one generation to the other? No. Apart from BRCA1 and 2, there are other genes which have been found to be responsible for transmission of cancers. We have PALB2, we have CHEK, we have ATM, then we have STK11, CDH1, P10, P53 and NF1. These are the different genes which are also have a propensity to cause cancer in various organ systems. So when we do this hereditary cancer panel testing, we will get to know of all of the scientists would look into all of these particular genes, and if any of these genes are present, then a report is dished out to the unaffected individual, that is not a patient, to the individual saying that, hey, you have a chance of developing these tumors. And trust me, these tests are only to be done by a prescription, with the prescription of a medical oncologist, and only if you are ready to know the future. It's good to get these tests done because you can identify whether you have a higher chance. It's good to get these tests done so that you can identify whether you have a chance of developing a cancer, whether you are prone to develop a cancer, and cut the tumor in the bud. We do regular screening and treat it in the earliest stage. An important question: who should be tested for this hereditary panel testing? If you are a patient, get it done. If you have a family member with a breast cancer or ovarian cancer or pancreatic cancer or prostate cancer, if you have a male member in the family who has a breast cancer or a prostate cancer, get it done. Now the big question: what happens if you are tested positive? That is, you don't have any disease, but you tested positive for a hereditary cancer panel testing. That report comes that yes, you have a mutation which would put you at a higher risk. Trust me, there is an 80% higher chance of developing a malignancy if any of these tests come positive. What then happens? Like I discussed, we would do regular screening, once in 6 months screening on all of these organ systems and identify and then treat it through surgery. There's another method, going the Angelina Jolie method. If you have a BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutation, in these situations, you could choose to go in for a prophylactic bilateral mastectomy, that is removal of the breasts. This is a nipple sparing surgery, so therefore it will be filled with either fat or another muscle, or you could use even silicone breast implants. And along with that, there is a prophylactic bilateral oophorectomy, that is both the ovaries would also be removed, because the ovaries and the breasts are the most common sites where a cancer can develop. But does this mean that your risk becomes zero after that? No. Even despite a removal of these two organ systems, there is always a risk. Although it drastically falls, there is a small amount of risk, around 5 to 10% of chance that you might yet develop a cancer. So therefore, screening is of utmost importance. So friends, we spoke about hereditary breast cancer testing. We spoke about when to get it done, what to do if it comes positive. Well, the most important decision that you and your family has to take is to be decisive, to be attentive, vigilant, and to always be positive, because science is growing by leaps and bounds. There are different methodologies to identify, catch, and kill stuff before they originate. So my dear friends, if you like this video, I would request you to press the like button, subscribe and share this video to all people whom you think would benefit from it. Your mother, your family members, as well as your close friends. Signing off, Dr. Rajeev Vijayakumar, from Medical Oncologist from BGS Global, Bangalore. Thank you.